Good afternoon, dear friends. Linda Hall here with another coffee talk. I've got my coffee in one of the mugs I was gifted with on Mother's Day. Thank you, Riley. I love you too. And as a message to tell you that I love you and am so honored to be here with you at least once a week while we live through this time that we're finding ourselves in. I hope you've settled into a comfy seat with your favorite beverage for the next 20 minutes or so, because now we're going to start talking. Today is going to be a little different from what I've been doing. This weekend, we're celebrating our graduates, and because I'm working on a couple more time-intensive pieces, the staff and I thought it might be time to pull something out of Orchard's musical archives on Moses. Some of you might recall that way back in 2013, the Chancel Choir, under the direction of Reverend Suzanne Goodwin and with Daniel Drummond on the piano, presented the message in music. This Ken Medema piece, entitled Moses, took the place of the sermon on April 21st, 2013. On that day, we listened to and we watched the Chancel Choir sing while visuals were shown on the screen. The visuals were created using various pieces of a stained glass window I found on Moses. And way back then, I put them all together in a mini movie and posted it on YouTube. Yes, we had a YouTube channel even back then. It's just now been used more recently with our Sunday worship services and our weekly weekday worship experiences. Before hearing the choir piece, however, I'd like to first read a devotion that I found online on Gateway Devotions, written by Richard Stearns. It's focused on part of the Moses story found in Exodus chapter 4. Let us hear Exodus 4, 2, and 3. Then the Lord asked him, "What is that in your hand?" "A shepherd's staff," Moses replied. "Throw it on the ground," the Lord told him. It was just another ordinary day. Nothing special, nothing out of the norm. For Moses, it was pretty much the same routine it had been for the past 40 years. Wake up, take care of the sheep all day, go to bed, start all over the next day. His years spent growing up as a prince in Pharaoh's palace on the beautiful banks of the Nile seemed a lifetime away. Now his days consisted of taking care of his father-in-law's flocks of sheep out on the dry and dusty desert plains of Midian. At 80 years old, his life was over. Whatever dreams he may have once had were now long gone. It wasn't a horrible life. In fact, it was pretty peaceful. In spite of his education and learning, Moses had come to accept his lot in life and resigned himself to it. But then he came across a burning bush. God asked him a question, and life as Moses knew it forever changed. The sight of a bush burning in the desert probably wasn't terribly shocking to Moses. But then, when the bush continued to blaze without burning up, his curiosity was piqued, and he drew closer to investigate. At that moment, Moses heard God's voice coming from within the burning bush, calling him by name. Imagine how Moses felt when God told him he had seen the agony of his people in Egypt and heard their cries of deliverance, and he was sending Moses to lead them out. For 40 years, he had led nothing but sheep. Is it any wonder that Moses responded with, "What if they don't believe me or listen to me? What if they say, 'The Lord never appeared to you'?" Do you know how God chose to answer Moses' question? With a seemingly unrelated question of his own. "What's in your hand?" Now Moses must have wondered why God would ask him a question he obviously knew the answer to. But he simply replied, "A shepherd's staff." And then God commanded, "Throw it on the ground, Moses." So Moses threw it on the ground, and lo and behold, it turned into a snake. Naturally, Moses turned and ran. That is, until he was stopped in his tracks by God's command to pick up the snake by its tail. With a considerable amount of nervousness, Moses cautiously reached out his hand and picked the snake up by its tail, and immediately it became a staff again. We don't know how long Moses had been using that particular staff, but odds are that it was quite a while. Most likely, he had grown pretty familiar with all of the staff's little nicks and grooves, and the passage of time had probably weathered the wood to the point where it was now smooth and completely at home in his hand. His staff represented so much more than just a walking stick. First, it represented his identity. Just as a stethoscope represents a doctor or a tool belt represents a mechanic, Moses' staff was the most recognizable symbol of his occupation as a shepherd, his career, his job. Secondly, it was a symbol of his income. In those days, people didn't have bank accounts, credit cards, or hedge funds. They had cattle, goats, and sheep. And as a caretaker of his father-in-law's flocks of sheep, Moses' income, his money and possessions, were inextricably linked to his position. And the third thing the staff symbolized was Moses' influence. Because when a shepherd uses his staff to move sheep from point A to point B, he is essentially influencing them. So in essence, when God asked Moses, "What's in your hand?" and told him to throw it on the ground, God was saying, "Are you going to lay down your identity, surrender your income, let go of your influence? Because if you do, I'll take something that seems dead to you and I'll make it come alive. I'll make a miracle out of it. It may seem like an insignificant stick to you, but if you surrender it to my hands, I'll do things you could never imagine possible." The question that God asked Moses so many years ago still resonates just as strongly today. What's in your hand? Your talent, background, education, freedom, health, contacts, opportunities, mind, passions, wealth, ideas, creativity? What's in your hand? The author of the devotion ends by saying, so ask yourself today, what's in my hand? And the Moses piece we're going to listen to further asks us, what do you hold in your hand today? To what or to whom are you bound? Are you willing to give it to God right now? Listen now, as we once again, or for some of us for the first time, hear the message of Moses, sung by the members of the 2013 Chancel Choir. A beautifully done, powerful message by our chancel choir, asking us the question posed to Moses by God. What's in your hand? Are you willing to give it up? Let it go? Throw it down? Until next time, friends, stay well.